Mr. Ambassador.
Sir.
Welcome.
Thank you, it's a pleasure.
And Madame Papoulias.
How do you do?
Excellent, nice to see you.
And Dr. Carroll, President.
Well, you and I will go over in front of the fireplace for a picture.
Yes, Mr. President.
And then you will join us for a family picture.
Thank you.
Thank you. Right.
Mr. President, may I present you that is actually between me, to you as an ambassador of Greece, and also the letters of recall of my predecessor. It's a great honor, Mr. President, to be the ambassador of Greece in your great country and next to you.
Well, we're pleased to have you here and delighted with our relationship with your country. And I know now we also have the signing of the papers all completed on the bases and so forth. And we're very happy with our relationship.
Thank you, Mr. President. I can assure you that the Greek government looks forward to a very fruitful and very friendly relations between the United States and Greece. We have been allies since the beginning of our countries, of
yes.
our states,
yes.
Mr. President, and we have always looked upon the United States as our great ally in time.
Well, we feel the same way.
There is also this occasion, Mr. President, conveyed to you on behalf of President Karamanlis his personal words of sympathy and his very deep condolences for the loss of the young American Marines. He asked me
Thank
to convey his personal, very, very sincere deep condolences, Mr. President.
Thank you very much. It has been a sad occasion.
Very sad that it has touched all of us.
Would you like that?
It'll be a pretty picture.
I'm going here to serve the nations and I'll do all I can.
I know you will. We're very happy. I hope you'll be happy.
Thank you. President, His Royal Highness Prince Bandar.
Yes.
Ambassador of the King of Saudi Arabia.
Good to see you.
Good to see you, Mr. President.
Now, it's Your Royal Highness, Mr. Ambassador.
From a fighter pilot to an ambassador.
Yes.
It's a great honor for me to come and present to you my speeches today.
Well, let's go over in front of the fireplace.
Very good.
Mr. President, Minister Sirai.
How do you do?
Nice
to see you.
The honor of collecting them now.
Well, we're glad that you're here. I think you may find there are even as many hazards in this job as there were in being a firefighter.
I think a little bit more, Mr. President, as Bud would contest.
Well, it's good to have you.
It's an honor for me to be here presenting to the Saudi people, to you and our great friends in this country.
Well, we're grateful for the many things that you've done with regard to problems over there. This last one is a most difficult problem.
Absolutely. We, on behalf of His Majesty and the Saudi people, I want to extend our profound sorrow and condolences to you, the American people and the families of those brave men. But peace has never been cheap anyway.
No.
It is very, they went in a very honorable way.
And they're not going to figure this out.
I'm sure of that.
But we have some circumstantial evidence, purely circumstantial. But it's enough to convince me that I think our Iranian friends were back of this.
His Majesty, I spoke with him yesterday, and he's convinced that this is so too, from our
yes.
side and feelings. And I think this is the time that they should know who's their enemies and their friends.
Yes.
Mr. President, can we ask the Minister to step in for a picture also with you?
Yes.
Thank you.
It'd be an honor.
Thank you.
Well, again, it's a great pleasure to have
Thank you, sir. I'm proud to see you
again.
Please give my respect to Mrs. Reagan.
I sure will.
Thank you.
Yes.
Bye.
Well, that's not goodbye. Just see you later.
See you later. Au revoir.
I'm sorry.
Oh, not at all.
Good.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right, Babs. Well, I'm sorry you've been getting a little jammed up out there.
Yes, we sympathize with you today, sir.
But we also have some very inspiring guests here. Like the young man who walked across from Idaho to Baltimore, the blind boy, the white king. And he came in with several others just to try and prove that the answer to handicaps is not more handouts, it's giving a chance to become a part of the community and move themselves. An 18-year-old girl, now a freshman at Notre Dame. I can't get used to saying that, but freshman.
Fresh
high school graduate. She has won the General Motors Science Award of the Year. Now think of this, 18 years old now. She has found out or discovered that in reptiles and so forth, fossils and remains, you can, from the rings in the teeth, now determine better and more accurately the age and everything and how far back they go than you do from the whole skeleton. You don't need to find the rest of the skeleton. You can establish all of this. The whole world of science, a 17-year-old did that in high school.
I think I'll go home and hit my dad.
Well, listen, I wanted to meet briefly with all of you today, but I want to thank you all for what you've been doing and the things that have interested just all of us. Thank you, given me to Mike Deaver, and I'm gratified for Babs being part of all this, what she has done, and Roberta Bow, though she couldn't be here today. But I just kept some cue sheets here because I wanted you to know that, well, I'm pleased to hear that pension reform is moving so swiftly in the Senate, and the child support enforcement reform is moving in the House. And I share with you the goal of getting these initiatives enacted into law as soon as possible. As to the matter of the non-pension fund-related tax measures, you began to discuss with us back in July and wrapped up last Friday. I've made some decisions that I believe reflect a balance between equity and need and are responsible within the overall context of the economy at this time. And I hope we can get them adopted as soon as possible. I agree with you that IRA tax deductions for working spouses should be extended to non-working spouses, and that we should change current restrictions governing the treatment of taxable alimony for IRA deductions. And we'll work to permit nonprofit dependent care organizations to be treated as tax-exempt organizations, and we'll work to restructure the dependent care tax credits so that more benefits become available for those with lower incomes. And now, I could go on, there are more of them, but I think I will turn to Ed to cover each of these in more detail.
If they have anything to match theirs, then suddenly they see us posting about cutting back thousands of weapons. We've got to make our people understand that we're talking a different kind of weapon.
It drives home a very important point, Mr. President, and that is that modernization is really the key. It isn't the raw numbers. People will measure our numbers against the Soviet numbers and say that, well, they're even. But the fact is, they have modernized and we have not. So both the tactics as well as the INF is a perfect example of modernization. We will, the Persians and the ground-mounted missiles won't give us nearly as many warheads as